I'm Science Mom, this is Math Dad, and we're back for another challenge problem.
If you have a challenge problem you'd like to see us try, please send it to mathdadchallenge@gmail.com, and I'll give it a look over, but don't send it to Science Mom. This is one of those classic math problems where you have two trains headed towards each other on a collision course.
I never liked those problems.
All right, well, let's see if you can handle this one. So the towns are 300 miles apart where the trains start from. The first train is traveling at 35 miles per hour, the second train is traveling at 25 miles per hour, and in between these trains, we've got a bee that's flying back and forth between these trains at 100 miles per hour, and with no stop time, just back and forth. And the question is, how many miles has the bee flown when the trains meet?
All right.
Just to give you a bit of an illustration here, if I drag this, you see the bee's flight, it goes back and forth, and it actually goes back and forth infinitely many times before they meet, because it's traveling at a faster speed than their combined speed.
That's pretty cool. So I like this problem because of the bee. The bee's fun.
The bee is indeed kind of fun.
Yeah.
All right. So I'm giving you 2 minutes to solve this problem. You can draw on this current screen, or if you wanted to click back to see the interactive screen, you can go to the other one. Any questions?
Nope.
All right.
Pause the video and try it yourself.
Go.
All right. The first thing I'm going to do is...
No, this is a drawing screen.
Oh, it's a... So I can't do the
slider. You can't drag on this one.
Oh, okay. Okay, so if these were traveling... And they're going to meet right here.
Correct.
This one's going a little bit slower, and this one's going a little faster.
Other way around.
Yeah. Okay, that makes sense. So this is the train. This is the car train going at 35 miles per hour. This one's going at 25 miles per hour. They meet closer to this guy because he was going a little slower. And the bee. How far does the bee travel? So this reminds me a little bit, you know, with the infinite series questions you've asked before, where we're adding up a sum, there's often a think around way to do it that's a little easier than adding up the distances. Because I could figure out when the bee, you know, how long this length is by.
Right.
And then add it to the next. But
I'm only giving you 2 minutes.
Yeah, that would take a bit of time, and there's got to be a faster way to do it. And that faster way is elusive. You know, I just kind of want to, like, draw cartoons of, like, a little superhero bee. And with, like, super fast wings, and he's just like, 100 miles per hour, and I'm, like, back and forth. Like, this is such a fun idea. I love the idea of the bee. But how far does he go in total?
Hyped up on caffeine or something. Sugar.
Hmm.
10 seconds.
Oh my gosh. With no stop time. I'm going to say 300 just as a kind of a guess. Nope.
Incorrect. So, what was the shortcut on this one? Well, it sounds like a terribly complicated problem. However, if you notice one thing, all you really need to know is how long it takes for the trains to meet.
Oh my gosh! That's so cool!
Yes, isn't it?
I love it!
Alright, so all together, one train's going 25 miles per hour, the other's going 35 miles per hour, so they're approaching at 60 miles per hour. If you add those two together, we've got to go 60 miles per hour for a total of 300 miles. So how many hours would that take?
Hold on a second.
Five hours. Okay.
Yep. So the bee's traveling 5 hours at 100 miles per hour, so it travels 500 miles.
500 miles.
That is so cool. Yep. Very nice shortcut. I like it.
Thanks.